Welcome to this El Nino briefing created February 10th, 2015. My name is Mark O'Malley with the National Weather Service in Phoenix. El Nino is a seasonal and persistent abnormally warm pool of water across the equatorial Pacific Ocean that couples with the atmosphere to create changes in the overall atmospheric circulation pattern and in turn weather patterns. Specifically, we look at the sea surface temperature anomalies near the equator in the East Central Pacific. This key Niño 3.4 region, we need warm water of at least a half a degree Celsius above normal to persist for several consecutive months in order to effectively change the weather patterns downstream and directed towards the United States. In these images and animations, warm water has been prevalent for several months over parts of the equatorial Pacific. However, persistent very warm water has been difficult to come by across all the Niño regions. As a result, we have only been barely reaching the threshold for El Nino conditions this winter. In forecasting El Nino, much of what eventually is measured at the surface of the ocean can be traced to events occurring several hundred meters below the surface. Organized deep ocean waves move massive amounts of water west to east, as well as from the ocean depths to the surface and vice versa. This phenomenon, called an oceanic Kelvin wave, has helped occasionally warm the equatorial Pacific, as seen here in the beginning of December. But it has also contributed to occasional cooling at the surface, like we have seen here at the end of January. Because of this, we are only just touching El Nino conditions, and the necessary ocean-atmospheric linkage that impacts weather patterns has not been seen over a prolonged season period. We can also look at sea surface temperature anomalies across the entire Pacific Basin for hints in what could happen in the atmosphere. While the warmest water along the equator contains the most energy and the potential impact into the atmospheric flow pattern, the warmer than usual waters hugging the North American coast have historically been favorable for West Coast precipitation, especially during El Nino events. However, water along the equator in the Far East Pacific has been normal or even cooler than normal recently, while West Pacific waters have been warmer than normal. This is opposite of what we would typically expect during a classic mature El Nino event. When forecasting sea surface temperatures, we look at several different dynamical and statistical models focusing on the Niño 3.4 region. By utilizing various model solutions produced from different countries, we can visualize both the spread and average of all the models to get a sense of forecast confidence and the most likely outcome. From all these models, we can see the most likely outcome, or average yield sea surface temperatures just above a half degree Celsius, the El Niño threshold for several months into this spring. Thereafter, the model spread grows, yielding more forecast uncertainty. However, the average and best grouping of models indicates more neutral conditions prevailing for the summer and beyond. Another way to quantify the spread and uncertainty in forecasting El Niño is using probabilities of occurrence. In this graph, we see around a 55% chance of El Niño prevailing into early spring and slowly declining probabilities thereafter. By the end of the spring, there's about a 50-50% chance of either El Niño or neutral conditions, with ENSO neutral becoming the most likely outcome by the summer. That said, there are some positive signs lately in the warm Central Pacific El Niño waters. They may start to link with and influence the atmosphere. More concentrated thunderstorm clusters have been pulsing southwest of the Hawaiian Islands this past week. Meanwhile, a burst of westerly winds in the low levels has been coincident with these thunderstorms, and if persistent, would be indicative of a more El Niño-like atmospheric behavior. However, the problem is once we get into the spring months, the ability for the atmosphere to maintain a feedback response with the ocean tapers off, and the El Niño influence really wanes. So in summary, there's nearly 55% chance of El Niño prevailing into the spring, with more neutral conditions developing during the summer. This is only a weak El Niño event, which really has only very limited to no real predictable influence on weather in Southeast California and Arizona. And the further into spring we head, the less El Niño will impact the weather patterns across the United States. So thank you for viewing this multimedia briefing. You may also find us on the web, Facebook, and Twitter at the addresses listed here.